Hello everyone, welcome to Honara's Arts and Lifestyle channel. Today I will be showing you how to clean the brass idols or murtis after we have done the Abhisheka or Alankara during a festival. I am doing this video based on several requests from my subscribers and people who have been viewing my videos. They have requested me to show how to maintain these kind of brass idols, and hence the reason why I am doing this video. Dear friends, I'm actually getting a lot of inquiry from you all asking me where did I purchase this idol, what is the height and what is the cost. So let me just tell you a few things here. First and the foremost thing, this idol was not something that I purchased. It was given to me by Durga Parameshwari temple as a gift or a blessing, because I did a lot of seva in the temple for 2 years, and they wanted to give me something in return, and I told them that I'm not going to accept money, and I told them that if they have to give me something, then I would really like to take Durga's idol home. So that is why they actually gave me the idol, which was already worshipped at the temple. Okay, so this idol weighs somewhere between 12 to 15 kgs and it is about 14 inch in height. I don't know what is the cost of this, but if you ask me, if we go to a very good antique showroom and all, I'm expecting that this would cost somewhere between 12 to 15,000 rupees. And recently I inquired at one of the shops in KR Market, Bangalore. Okay, so in KR Market, Bangalore, there is one entire street. I think it's called Avenue Road or something, I don't remember. But that entire street, there are only brass and copper items available. And you won't believe if I tell you that there are varieties of beautiful idols which are there, beautiful diyas which are there made of brass. And this street is not going to be crowded. It is not like the street which is there in the Masjid Road. The Masjid Road is going to be very crowded, but this particular road is not crowded. So if you have your own vehicle, you can just go safely, take the precautions, use the mask and the sanitizer and all, and you can just walk into any of the store and look at the items and you can purchase. I think they also customize the idols. So in case if you want an idol just like this, show them the video and they should be able to do it. So recently when I inquired in one of the shops, they have told me that a pure Panchaloha idol like this, like the one that I have shown you in the picture, this will cost about 12,500 rupees. Okay, this is about 10 inches in height, and it is 1,250 rupees per kg is what they are charging. But if you notice very clearly, this is actually Mariamma, this is not Durga, because it is holding a cup in the left hand. Okay, so I'm thinking of getting this customized for a friend of mine. So as soon as that is done, and if I find that the idol is satisfactory, then I will be sharing all the details, including the contact details and all, with you all, so that you can walk into those stores or you can just order it online. I'm pretty sure they will be able to ship it to your address also. So please give me some time, let me do my inquiry, the background checks, and little bit of research before I give you the contacts of where you can buy an idol like this. So my idol, from where the temple people got it, we have no clue about it. I won't be able to give you the source of the maker of this particular idol, but I'll try to give you the contact who can actually do a similar idol, and I'll even show you the photo after they have made one, so that you can decide on the quality and then purchase. I'm not very sure whether my idol is a pure brass or pure Panchaloha, but I tend to believe that it is Panchaloha because of the shine that it has. Usually the brass idols, they get dim after 3 to 4 days or a week of washing. This Durga idol doesn't become dull. Okay, I have seen it. Even if it becomes dull, it's a very light coating that appears. It's not the proper brass that you get outside and all. So I'm not very sure whether this is a brass or a Panchaloha. But whenever you are buying an idol, especially this kind of a Durga idol, make sure that it is not antique finish. So when I say antique finish, it means it has got black lines like this that you can see. Though the brass idol will be very new, they purposefully would have made a polish like this. So what happens when you buy an antique finish idol? No matter how you wash it, it is not going to shine like my Durga idol. Okay. So if you want the shine that you need for my Durga idol, then the polish that you need to go for is a natural finish. Don't ask for antique finish. Even if an idol is already antique finish, you can always ask them to make another fresh coat of brass coating or Panchaloha coating on it. That is going to be expensive. Okay, like for my idol, which was about 6 inches to 7 inches height, I think they had charged somewhere around 2,000 rupees. So I'm not sure how expensive it's going to be. So when you are purchasing the idols itself, make sure that the polish is not of the antique finish. Then it'll be a lot easier for you to maintain. But no matter what kind of a finish you buy, you will have to wash it every week. That is a thumb rule. And if you are very sure that you won't be able to wash them every week or once in 15 days, then I would suggest you to go for antique finish. Because in antique finish, what happens? Even if it becomes a little dark, it will still look beautiful because the original polish itself will be in a darker shade. One thing that I want you all to remember is that it is mandatory to clean the idols after doing Abhishekam. Like for example, even as per the rituals, after you finish all the Abhishekam that I have told you in one of my videos, you will have to wash the idol with hot water. It is considered very good as per rituals also, very auspicious. And not just that, this hot water is going to be an advantage for us. Why? Because we would have done Abhisheka using ghee, oil and all these stuff, which is going to be very sticky and it's going to form a coat on the idol. So when we put the hot water, what happens? Everything just washes off and it just melts off from the brass, thus helping in maintaining the brass quality. The way in which I have cleaned my brass idol after Navratri was that I did Abhisheka to the brass idol on the very first day of Navratri. Okay, and after that I have not touched the brass idol at all. I have not used any soap or pitambari to wash the brass idol after doing Abhishekam. I have just wiped it, did the Alankaram and I kept it for Navratri. And after 9 days, that is on the last day of Navratri, again I have done the Abhishekam. The second time when I took the idol to do the Abhishekam, before doing it, what I have done is, I washed it with pitambari and patted it dry, okay? One very important thing when you have to maintain the brass idols is that just washing is not going to be sufficient. You have to dry the brass perfectly. That is, take a very good cotton cloth, a white cotton cloth, pat it enough so that there isn't even a single drop of water on the brass idol. No matter how neatly you have cleaned the idols, unless you don't remove the water in it, it is going to give you black spots. Now I'm going to show you two ways of cleaning these brass idols. Many of you might already be aware that we actually use tamarind to clean it also. But because some of them have actually requested me to show it, that is why I'm making this video. So there are two ways of doing it. The first way in which we do it is by using pitambari. So here I'm showing you the packet of pitambari that we get in the shops. If you're staying in other parts of India where you are not going to get this pitambari, you can as well order it from either Big Basket or from Amazon. You get this pitambari in all sizes, from small packets to the very big packets and all. And one small packet of pitambari, if you're washing only one idol, then I think it'll last for 2 months or something like that, more than that. After opening the pitambari packet, this is the pink powder that we get. So we will be using this for cleaning. Along with that, we are also going to use utensil cleaner, something like Vim liquid or a Pril, and a Scotch Brite sponge like this. We'll be using the green side of the sponge. So wet the sponge first. Put little bit of Vim liquid or Pril on it. And then little bit of pitambari. And use this to clean the idol. Thank you. After washing the brass idol for the first time with water, you need to ensure that there is no residue of pitambari anywhere in the idol. For this, you will have to use a toothbrush and rub it everywhere wherever there are carvings on the idol. The reason why this step is very important is because if there are any pitambari residue left on the brass idol, that particular area will become black permanently. That is why we need to be very careful when we are using pitambari. And also, friends, please note that extensive use of pitambari is going to hurt our hands, okay? Like if there is one or two or three idols of brass and you are going to clean it with pitambari, that is fine. But in case if there are too many brass items in your house and if you are going to use only pitambari to clean it and you do it in a single day, then your hands are going to be cut, okay? So that is why if you are going to wash too many brass items with pitambari, I suggest you wear a glove. Now I'll be showing you how to clean the Sai Baba idol. This is actually an antique finish. As you can see, it has got black lines and all. I will be using tamarind to clean this. So first and the foremost thing is to soak the tamarind in warm water for like 10 to 15 minutes. And the cleaning process is going to be exactly similar that we did earlier. Take a sponge, put little bit of utensil cleaner like Vim or Pril, and then little bit of tamarind, and just scrub the idol. Please note that this idol will not be cleaned to the level of my Durga idol. The reason being, the original polish of this particular idol is an antique polish, and that is why it is going to be a little dull when compared to the Durga idol. Now, after washing the idols, please make sure that you wipe these idols very well with a white cotton cloth. Over here, the cotton cloth that I have taken is that of lungi. Okay, we get lungi in white color. In Kannada we call this as panche. So I have taken half of this panche to clean the idols. You can even use a soft quality of the lungi that we get. We call it as mal panche. Okay, so even that quality, if you can use, that will be even better, because one thing, it's going to be very soft and it can absorb water very quickly. And please make sure that there is not even a single drop of water on the idol, otherwise that area is going to become black. So friends, this is how I clean my brass idols and I maintain it. I do this every week or at least once in 15 days to ensure that, you know, the idols are very clean. Durga has to be cleaned every week because this is the idol which was worshipped at the temple. The rest of the idols, either I clean it once a week or once in 15 days. So if you have liked today's video, then please click on the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.